Hi, this is Marc Gee reporting for Liverpool Live here in New Brighton, the Las Vegas of the Northwest, in Caffe Cream, the award-winning Caffe Cream, and I'm absolutely delighted to be in the company of Kevin Sampson here today, who's doing a book launch of his new book called The Killing Pool. Kevin, it's lovely to meet you.
It's lovely to be here in the award-winning Caffe Cream with the lovely Marc Gee.
Oh, thank you very much.
So, I'm here doing a Wirral book launch for the new book, The Killing Pool. And we'll get onto that in a little while, but I want to know what you're doing in sunny New Brighton.
Well, funny enough, the movie I'd made called Owl's Lads has been shown.
Fine movie.
All right, thank you. Thanks, yeah. Well, it's 10 years old, and as a sort of like, they're doing a Q&A at the Light Cinema, which unfortunately coincides with your book launch. Otherwise, I would be here, and I dare say you would be eating popcorn.
I would.
At Owl's Lads.
You'd have to try and stop
yes,
me.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Okay. Tell us a little bit about your book,
Kevin. So the book's called The Killing Pool, and it's my first ever out-and-out detective thriller. I've written crime books before. I've done books that tell crime stories set in Liverpool, mainly from the point of view of the underworld figures, from the gangsters, if you like, from the villains. But this is the first in a series of detective thrillers featuring a Liverpool-based drug surveillance officer called DCI Billy McCartney, and his role, putting it simplistically, is to break up the major international drug dealing cartels. That's his area of specialism, and in the Killing Pool, he's on the tail of a Liverpool Kurdish heroin smuggling ring, and it's come to the real nitty gritty. He's about 48 hours away from landing the ne'er-do-wells. But on page one, we encounter a body in Dockland and Scrubland near the docks. And it's a case of not just finding out who done it, but who is it, because he's been beheaded, and so they have to find out who it is,
all right,
what the connection is with the crime. So it's
not a comedy then?
It's not too, there are some like yeah, moments, relieving all the gore and the adrenaline, but no, it's mainly, you know, it's a gritty thriller.
Well, that's great. How much research did you do, Kevin, for it?
Well, read The Echo every day.
Yeah, so there's a lot of info in there, yeah.
But in terms of the real, you know, the scientific procedural stuff, that, you know, it's advisable to get that as accurate as you possibly can. I was dead lucky in that I was able to call on some real kind of top level assistants from a couple of retired detectives. One of them who worked for what would now be the Matrix, you know, the sort of special organised crime agency, and the other guy who actually specialised, you know, in drug crime. So both of them had a real level of expertise and were able to input into what I'd done, and just put me on the right path as to, you know, what, how something like that would play.
Yeah, that's great. I mean, see, I'm a stickler for research. Funny enough, I had a crime book as well called Autumn Kill, and I actually had to, you know, go and do a lot of research. Got in contact with Walton Prison, and they were really, you know, helpful. Took me all around the bowels and inside of the prison just to give me a feel of the place and things like that.
And of course, Owl's Lads is a crime tale, isn't it?
For
the uninitiated,
yeah,
it's about how a firm of scousers became Al Capone's personal bodyguard.
Yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. And I came across purely by accident. It was an article in The Echo where Sylvester Stallone was walking out of a nightclub, and lo and behold, his two bodyguards with him in Hollywood were from Bootle. And this guy propped up his head behind The Echo and said, "That's nothing, Al Capone's had scousers working for him," and that was the idea for it. Little, you know, something simple.
Capone's endorsement was, you know, forget the fighting Irish, forget all the mad Sicilians, your Liverpudlians, your scousers, or who you want to go into the trenches with, didn't you?
Yeah. So from that, it you know, progressed. I still hold the world record of having the worst theatrical review in the world. And amazing, that was for Owl's Lads, which again, it's like finished up as a movie. So, you know, it's a crazy world out there. You say this is possibly a trilogy of stories. You have more ideas for
definitely,
a couple of other books?
Definitely got more plans for McCartney. I mean, given that his area of specialism is drug crime, you know, there's certainly no shortage of locations that we could take him to. So I've got initial plans for him. The next one's going to be set in Ibiza and Morocco, Liverpool. They'll all have the roots in Liverpool, but it'll take him to Ibiza and Morocco. There's an idea for one in southern Spain, one in
Amsterdam. Why Ibiza?
Oh, because of the, you know, the club culture, and wherever there's a really vibrant club culture and party culture, you tend to find that there's a satellite narcotics industry, and you know, those are kind of rich areas for, you know, for a novelist to write about.
Yeah, funny enough, I'm doing something at the moment with Ibiza as well. Not necessarily for that reason, but because of that sort of like background attached to it. And also it would be nice to work in the sunshine a little bit
wouldn't it?
Yeah. So this is, you know, one of possibly three books, or do you see it as an ongoing tale?
I've certainly got enough material for three. I'd be surprised and disappointed if there weren't at least three. Then it's time to take stock, see how they've been received, you know, if there's a demand for them, then I would certainly, you know, I've got loads of ideas for future novels. But if no one's interested, then I'll go back to my slot outside TK Maxx and do my Andy Williams impersonations.
Well, I might be with you, Kevin. It's really nice to meet you. I hope the book goes exceptionally well for you and tonight. And I look forward to having a pint with you sometime, Kevin.
Lovely.
And we can talk about football and other things.
Brilliant.
Okay, great, Kevin.
Good one.
Cheers.
Good luck tonight.
And thank you.